Hey, Chris Menard here. I have a great Excel video. I had a question from one of my YouTube subscribers. This video is going to use three functions: if, isEven, and roundup. And they're going to be nested together. So the question that I had is they have data that they use. In the data, I made some sample data in column A. Normally, when you highlight these numbers and you say, okay, give me comma style with no decimal places, because they all end in 0.5, math rules say round them up. But that's not what they need for this. So I'm back here to the 0.5. They need any number that is even, forget about the decimal, to stay at 100. So 100.5 needs to go down to 100. Any number that is odd, again, forgetting about the 0.5, needs to round up. So 101.5 can go to 102. So I can't use the comma and decrease the decimals. That's not going to work for me. So we're going to use if, isEven, and roundup. And before we get into this, there are chapters down below if you want to jump around. Feel free to subscribe and also ring the bell. Let's look at this right now. So isEven is a great function. I've got some sample numbers in column C. I'm going to do isEve, hit tab. One argument, it wants to know, okay, what number do you want me to tell you if it's even or not? So I've got the number 500.1, and it returns true or false. It's that simple. I'm going to get a true here, and if someone says, well, that number is not even, it forgets about the decimals. It always rounds down. So 500.1, when I press enter, is true. It's looking at just the 500. The same thing with the 500.9. It's going to say true because, again, it's looking at the 500. So here we go. I'm just going to autofill this down. And it is working correctly. Both 101s are odd, so it says false. Just to mention this, I'm using isEven in this example, but there is an isOdd function also. So roundup is also being used. This is a great function. I'm saying no matter what, round up that number, and the question is how many decimals? I'm going to go zero. Round up will always round up, so this number should be 501. The number below it should be 501. Let's see if that's correct. I'm rounding up zero decimal places. Everything got rounded up. Just to quickly show you this, I'm not using it in this video, but I'd feel bad if I didn't show you, is round down. It is the opposite of round up. So now everything is getting round down. And finally, you've got the round function, by the way, just to show you this, equals round 500 comma zero. And if someone says, well, Chris, couldn't you just have used comma style with decimals? The answer is sure. But you can actually start getting in here and tweaking the number of decimals. So if I say -1, no matter what, if you notice that, 301 went down to 300. So you can start doing that. You do -1, -2, or you can do 1, 2, and those are decimals. Anyway, the functions we need in this two are these two right here. So I'll put them in yellow. So here we go with the if statement. So once again, when we're done, we should have no odd numbers. So I'm going to say equals if isEven round up, and I'm going to take A2 and round up zero decimal places, comma. Value of true, an if statement has three arguments. The last one is going to be false. So your statement, true and false. So if A2 is even, what do you want to do? Well, I'm going to round up. It would help if I could type. I'm going to round up A2 0 decimal places and add 1. Comma, what if A2 rounded up is false? Well, I'm going to do another round up. A2, 0 decimal places. I did 2 close parenth, and I'm going to subtract 1. Let's see if this is right. I should get, by the way, the number 100 here, and in cell B3, I should get 102. Missing something here. Round up A2. I don't need that. Sorry. There is your formula. I'm going to double click on it so you can see it again real big. So 100 is correct. I should get 102. Perfect. I should get the number 2, the number 4, the number 4, 1,000, and 1,002, and there you go. Now, if you're saying, Chris, why in the world is that function working? Really simple. Let me just widen this so you can see this all at one time. I'm going to double click in it. So we started off with the if statement, the first argument. And it starts off with round up. If I round up 100.5, 0 decimal places, that is the number 101. Then I said, okay, is that even? No, 101 is not even. So that means it is false. So if it's false, we're way over here on the third argument. What do you want to do? If it is false, round up A2, 0 places, which is again 101, and subtract 1. 101 minus 1 is 1,000. Now, in the next one down, I got 102, which again is correct. So let's double click on this one. And what we said is, same steps, is 101.5 rounded up 0 decimal places is 102. Is that even? I'm right over here. Is it even? Yes, 102 is even. So since that is true, we're in this middle section here. Well, then let's take 102, round up. Let's add 1. 102 plus 1 is 103. And don't forget about this minus 1. 103 minus 1 is the number 102. Anyway, it worked. Trust me, it's working. So there is an if statement with is even and round up all nested in there. But we also looked at round down and round. And don't forget, there is an is odd. So not too long of a video. We covered a lot of functions, and this was really cool. Feel free to subscribe again. Ring the bell. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.